Mars is a desolate planet. Although it does have an atmosphere, it's mostly just dried canals and canyons. When looking at photos of Mars, it's hard to imagine that it was ever sustainable for life. Yet, scientists have actually discovered ice on the dusty red planet. Yeah, there's ice on Mars. Which means there was once flowing water there as well. Mars is the third planet from the Sun, and it's the second planet from the Sun's habitable zone, or Goldilocks zone, which is just the right distance from the Sun to support life, not too hot or too cold. The atmosphere on Mars is thin and is just enough to keep things from burning up. It has water locked up under ice glaciers and rocks made from the same minerals we have here on Earth. It probably also has underground bases where aliens are silently watching our rovers from, but we don't know that for sure yet. Mars is cold, dry, and lacks an oxygen-rich atmosphere. In short, it's inhabitable for humans, but not totally inhabitable. Earth is actually kind of like what Mars used to be. A long time ago, Mars was a lot like our planet. It had a thicker atmosphere and it was warmer. It probably also had a magnetic field. Scientists hypothesized that over time, the magnetic field of Mars had weakened to a point that exposed the planet to the blunt force of solar storms and solar radiation that slowly cooked the atmosphere and made it evaporate away. As Mars lost its thick atmosphere, most of the surface water dried, turning the planet into a red desert marked with asteroid craters in a bloody hue. In the last four decades, we've sent multiple probes to Mars, and every single probe has solidified our understanding that Mars is currently not habitable for humans. The average temperature on Mars is minus 80 degrees Fahrenheit, which is way below the freezing point that humans can tolerate. The gravity, too, is different. The gravity on Mars is about one-third of the gravity on Earth. So a normal human on Earth can jump like John Carter on Mars. The biggest problem, however, is that the atmosphere of Mars is much thinner and contains more than 95% carbon dioxide and less than 1% oxygen. Humans, therefore, would not be able to breathe the air on Mars, and any future settlement on Mars would need ample amounts of oxygen at all times. So, Mars doesn't look like a great place to set up a colony, right? Well, it's actually on the top of the list for scientists. This is because, in theory, it can be terraformed to create conditions similar to what we have here on Earth. Around 100 years ago, terraforming was a fictional concept that writers dealt with in their sci-fi stories. In fact, our whole modern way of life would have been fictional a century ago. Technology has transformed the fiction of the past into reality of the present. Similarly, as time passed, scientists began to think about terraforming other planets. In the 1960s, Carl Sagan wrote a few articles about terraforming Venus, but the recent discourse on terraforming Mars was popularized by none other than Elon Musk, whose lifelong aim is to colonize Mars, eventually terraforming it to make it Earth 2.0. So, what exactly is terraforming? If you've seen Man of Steel, then you may remember the scene where Zod tried to terraform Earth to make it like Krypton through a world engine. Well, in an ideal scenario, we would need something similar to the world engine to terraform Mars into Earth. But we obviously don't have access to that level of technology yet. Terraforming is simply the process of modifying the atmosphere, temperature, and ecology of a planet to make it habitable. So, in theory, we don't need Krypton's world engine. We can create our own. So, before we get into terraforming, let's look at the similarities between Mars and Earth. A day on Mars is almost the same length as a day on Earth. Mars is also tilted on its axis, just like here on Earth. Mars is in the Goldilocks zone, so it can theoretically support life if conditions are perfect. Mars also has ice on its poles, so there's the possibility of water. This is where the similarities end. Now, what makes Mars inhabitable? Mars is currently far too cold for humans. we can live temperature in biobubbles, but turning Mars into Earth 2.0 will require warming the planet up entirely. There's too little oxygen in the atmosphere, which means we would need to find a way to change the oxygen levels of Mars. So this gives us two targets that we need to achieve on Mars through terraforming. Firstly, we need to heat the planet up, and secondly, we need more oxygen. There are several ways through which we can heat Mars up. The quickest way, according to Elon Musk, is to simply nuke the living daylights out of Mars. By dropping hundreds of thousands of nukes on Mars, especially the poles, we can vaporize the ice, which would release thousands of tons of trapped carbon dioxide and maybe even vaporize subsurface permafrost. If this happens, there will be enough particles in the thin atmosphere of Mars to trap more heat from the sun than Mars is currently able to. More heat will make the surface warmer, and it will theoretically kick off a chain reaction. But honestly, do you see humans nuking Mars in the future? This is highly unlikely and could even kick off an alien invasion. Another genius idea of Elon Musk is to create an array of special satellites around Mars, very much like Starlink. But while Starlink will beam down the internet on Earth, this array of satellites on Mars will reflect sunlight onto Mars. The idea is to focus as much sunlight on Mars as possible through giant space mirror satellites to increase the amount of energy being absorbed by the planet. Another way to heat up Mars is by strip mining the entire planet. Doing this would release the gases trapped within the minerals, but it's easier said than done. Strip mining the whole of Mars would require the energy equivalent to running 10,000 gigawatt nuclear reactors constantly for up to 40,000 years. If we had this much energy, we could solve all the problems here on Earth instead of looking for a new home. We basically need to focus enough energy on Mars to make it heat up right. So another way is to simply redirect comets, asteroids, meteors, and even any spare planets and moons we can find. Just redirect them and make them smash on Mars. Problem solved. Once again, this is easier said than done. To do this, we need to firstly find hundreds of meteors, comets, and asteroids, and then we need to come up with a novel way to steer these towards Mars. Theoretically, we can send a fleet of autonomous rockets to look for any stray objects, latch onto them, and then steer them towards Mars. Who knows, maybe this is how we'll end up terraforming Mars, but it seems pretty unlikely. Once we somehow manage to heat Mars up, we'll need to think about creating oxygen. It will also depend a lot on the terraforming method that we use. It's possible that once the planet starts heating up, it may see the growth of cyanobacteria, which single-handedly changed the fate of Earth billions of years ago. Cyanobacteria are microorganisms. Basically, they're the blue-green algae we see in the oceans. They were the first organisms on Earth capable of photosynthesis. Algae made oxygen possible on Earth. So, if cyanobacteria did it billions of years ago on Earth, then they can do it again on Mars in the future. Enriching the atmosphere of Mars with oxygen through cyanobacteria is going to take millions of years at least. So, it seems like theoretically we can terraform Mars, but in reality we simply don't have the technology to do it yet. Not in our lifetime. And not even in the next few generations. Alright. So, what can we do? 100 years ago, terraforming was a fictional concept. But today, scientists are actively thinking of ways to pull it off. Right now, we clearly don't have the technology to terraform Mars. In fact, we haven't even landed a man on there yet. From an economic perspective, it would simply take billions, if not trillions of dollars, to terraform Mars. All of this money can be used to make Earth a better place for everyone. But Elon Musk and many other visionaries like him want to turn humans into a multi-planetary civilization, and for this to happen, Mars has to be terraformed. We think that we're probably going to start off with a small settlement on Mars first. This alone is going to take us almost a decade. This small settlement of humans need to live on Mars for many generations and go through evolutionary phases that will change their bodies. The low gravity on Mars will increase the height of future Martians. There'll be blood chemical changes too. These future Martians will then be able to think of a more feasible way to terraform Mars. In any case, it'll take hundreds and thousands of years to make Mars habitable just like Earth. Till then, humans will have to live in secure biobubbles on Mars, and it seems like there's no other planet quite like Earth, which, for better or worse, will always be our home. What do you think? Will we ever be able to terraform Mars, or is this just a pipe dream? Let us know your thoughts by leaving a comment down below. And that's it for today's video. As always, if you enjoyed the video and want to see more, make sure you hit that subscribe button and stay updated on all of our latest releases. Other than that, thanks for tuning in, and I'll see you in the next one.